mezi spent some days speaking about the values
Omega.
Omega Church.
Ariko tuvugiza Omega,
but when we are talking about the values
nuko
of Omega,
ariyo tuba tubwira ari twe tuba twibwira.
It's because we are talking to Omega, we are talking to ourselves.
Ariko tuba tuvuga abakristo.
But in general we are referring abakristo to
aho baba bari hose.
Wherever they might be.
Si hano gusa.
Not just here.
Ahubwo naho umukristo wese ari.
But wherever a Christian
hari ukuntu akunda kwitwara.
There are ways they like to
Paul yaravuze ngo uyu muntu yiyaroye iyo umuntu agiye mu gisirikare.
Paul said that when someone are enrolled for
the army service,
they are being apart from
hari
the civilians.
Kire,
and there are things that characterize
soldiers.
And when you see that, you can recognize that this person is a real soldier. And there are things that characterize us as Christians. The real Christians. And when you meet one, you'll know that it's a Christian. And you know that it's an unbeliever. Or you know that the person is saved. Because there are things that show who they are. Not the way they are dressed. Not the way they walk. But the way they are. That's where we are. Because we are in the middle.
Amen.
Amen.
Someone asked
me about the topic.
Titre, the
he asked about the topic of this teaching. So sometimes it's very difficult for me to get
to because
I will say that the title is the Bible. But because I had to answer, I tried to look for an appropriate
title,
and I say the title is in the middle.
Or
in between. Say in between where we are coming from and where we are going. Because you have left where you used to be. We have not reached the place we are going to. So that's where we are. We are in between. And there is a way you have
hagati
to behave
tumeze.
And there is a way we
hagati
are.
Niho haturanga.
And that's what characterizes
kuko
us. Because,
aho tugeze,
because where we are so far,
gusubira inyuma.
We do not want to go
aho
back.
Turashaka kugera aho nyine
but
tugomba
we want
kugera
to reach where we are going.
Nitwari twagerayo.
But we have not yet reached.
Turacyari hagati.
We are still in between.
Amen.
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 Ugoro nyine niba mushaka titre mwandike ngo hagati.
So if you're looking for a title, just write that one.
Hari gitabo nigeze kuzuma kera nkiri umwana.
There is a book I read.
Twagisomaga mu ishuri.
I was still very young in school.
Bize muri anglophone barakizi.
Those who studied in the English system, they know it.
Titre yavugaga ngo the river between.
The title was the river between.
Ngo umugezi uri hagati.
The river between.
Ariko bene data kugira ngo nzamenye ngo aho hagati ahariho.
But beloved, for me to know where that in between was, it really took me long. It was confused. But in between, the river is between what and what? It's not difficult. It is between two banks. It is between two banks. And we are in between. We are between where we're coming from and our destination where we're heading to. That's what we're talking about today. So there is a way you have to behave while being there.
Amen.
Amen. Let's read. Philippians chapter 3, verse 7. And I will
continue.
But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. Now you see that he's in between, he's in the middle.
Ndetse n'ibintu byose mbitekereza ko ari igihombo kubw'ubutunzi butagira akagero aribwo.
What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Jesus Christ, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage that I may gain Christ.
And I
be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ.
guheshwa no kwizera.
The righteousness that comes from God on the basis of faith.
Kugira ngo mumenye,
I want to know Christ.
Menye n'imbaraga zo kuzuka kwe.
Yes, to know the power of his resurrection.
No gufatanya imibabaro ye.
And participation in his sufferings.
No kujya nshushanywa no gupfa kwe ngo hari ngere kumuzuko w'abapfuye.
Becoming like him in his death and so somehow attaining to the resurrection.
Suko maze kuhagera.
Not that I have already obtained this.
Suko maze guhabwa cyangwa ngombe maze gutunganya rwose ahubwo ndakurikira kugira ngo ahari mfate icyo Yesu Kristo yamfatiye.
Not that I have already obtained all this or have arrived at my goal, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me.
Bene data, sinibwira yuko maze kugifata, ariko kimwe cyo nibagirwa ibiri inyuma ngasingira ibiri imbere.
Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining towards what is ahead.
Ako reka ngasubiremo nimushaka mugasurinye kuko niko turi buvugeho.
Please highlight.
Bene data, sinibwira yuko maze kugifata, ariko kimwe nibagirwa ibiri inyuma ngasingira ibiri imbere. Ndamaranira kugira ngo dutanguranwa ngo mpabwe ingororano zo guhamagara kw'Imana muri Kristo Yesu kwavuye mu ijuru. None tugaye ku murongo wa 16 harakavuga ngo ariko rero ukuri dusohoyemo aba ariko dukurikiza.
Verse 14 says, I press on toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. Verse 16, only let us live up to what we have already attained.
Reka nsubire mu yenda.
Let me read.
Ngo bene data, sinibwe ariko maze kugishyikira, ariko icyo nkora ni kimwe, nibagirwa ibiri inyuma ntihatira gusingira ibiri imbere. Ibyo nayo ni amagambo Paul yandikiye Abafilipi.
Those are the words Paul wrote to Philippians.
Paul yandikiye Abafilipi.
He wrote to them.
Yari muri prison.
He was in jail.
Ariko muri prison inzandiko yandikiyemo.
But the letters he wrote from there.
Ni inzandiko zo guha abantu ibyiringiro.
They were letters to give them hope.
Wavuga ngo umuntu uri muri prison ahaniwe uha ubwiringiro abantu batari muri prison.
You can wonder how someone who is in jail is the one to encourage those who are not in there.
Mu Bafilipi igice cya mbere umurongo wa 12 harababwira ngo.
But in Philippians chapter 1 verse 12 it says.
Ngo nimubwire ngo ibyambayeho ngo byabaye inkomyi y'inkuru nziza.
He said, do not think that what has happened to me has been like a hindrance to the gospel.
Ngo ahubwo.
He said.
Byateje inkuru nziza imbere. Ngo byayiteje imbere.
It has actually contributed to advance the gospel.
Bene data.
Beloved.
Murabizi. Paul akigera mu Bafilipi bwa mbere.
You know when Paul got to Philippi the first time.
Muzi uko yahageze.
You know how he got there.
Yari hamwe na Silas.
He was with Silas.
Noneho batangira kuvuga ubutumwa.
And they started preaching the gospel.
Batangiye kuvuga ubutumwa.
And when they did that.
Noneho ngo bahura n'umukobwa.
They met a lady.
W'umujakazi w'abantu bakomeye.
A slave of very important people.
Wajyaga avugishwa n'imyuka mibi.
Who used to be possessed by the evil spirits.
None bakamuha amafaranga akayaha bashebuje.
And they will give her money and she will give money to the masters. None
imyuka mibi ya Satani.
And those evil spirits of
imenya abakozi b'Imana.
They recognized the servants of God.
Barimo bavuga ubutumwa.
And while they were preaching the gospel.
Nawe agashaka kurangaza.
She wanted to distract people.
Ariko Satani akisha agashaka kurangaza nkaho nawe avuga ibikwiriye.
The devil would try to distract people as if talking the right
thing. None akavuga ngo abo ni intumwa zisumba byose.
And you say these are the servants of the Most High.
Ngo mubumvire kuko barababwira iby'agakiza.
Obey what they are telling you because it is about salvation.
Ariko Paulo amenye umwuka umukoresha.
But Paul recognized the spirit that was at work and he rebuked that spirit.
Amaze kuyicyaha umwuka umuvamo wa mukobwa aba atakiragura mbese.
After rebuking that spirit, that girl was delivered and she will no longer prophesy.
Icyabaye?
And what happened?
Baba kuru bafashe Paul na Silas.
Those masters, they took Paul and Silas.
No, bajya kubarega babashyira muri prison.
And they took them to the leaders of that town.
Ariko bigeze nijoro.
And in the middle of the night.
Bahimbaza Imana.
They praised God.
Bahimbaje Imana.
And when they had praised God.
Fatiro za prison ziranyeganyega.
The foundations of that prison shook.
Ziranyeganyega n'ibirimo byose biranyeganyega.
They were shaken and everything in there.
N'iminyuru baba hambirije.
And the ropes they had used.
Ziranyeganyega iracika.
And they were torn.
Inzugi z'ibyuma zirafunguka.
And doors they were opened.
Ariko baraho.
But they were still there.
And
they said that the person who was
guarding
them, when he saw the doors open, he was afraid and he wanted to kill himself.
But
Paul and Silas say, be at peace, we are here, we didn't escape. The Bible tells us that that person was saved. But that story didn't end there. It got outside. And many people from that miracle they saved their
belief.
Paul, where he was, I think he used to think that those people, they are some who are not yet strong. They are still holding on to that miracle only. And now they have heard that I'm in prison. They will ask themselves, why am I not singing? Now he wrote this letter to encourage them. He gave this letter to give them hope.
Amen.
Amen.
And
when you look at these letters Paul wrote from the prison, they are letters of encouragement, of hope. Of encouraging them is to tell us how we should behave.
Amen.
Amen. Now he said that I do not think I have attained it. What I'm looking for, what I'm expecting, I have not yet got hold of it.
Amen.
Amen.
He's
in between. He's in between. And John says,
verse 2
to verse
3,
he said, dear friend, we are children of God. You think that it has been copied, it's the same words.
He
said, beloved, now we are children of God. But what will be, it has not yet made known. But what we know is that when Christ appears,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Ngo tuzasa nawe.
We'll be like him.
Ngo kuko
because
tuzaba
because
tumureba mu maso ku yandi.
We'll see him as he is face to face. And he say whoever have this hope
bagenda yiboneza.
They purify themselves.
Yes, ashimwe.
Praise be to Jesus.
Ngo turi hagati.
Say it, we are in between.
Reka nze mbereke.
Let me show you.
Tuvuge hano ni mwisi.
Let's say here it's in the world. And here it's in heaven.
Ngo bakundwa ubu twabaye abana b'Imana.
Now we are children of God.
Ubwo twarazamutse twageze hano.
It means we have
hano hagera umwana w'Imana.
Here you are.
Uko mwese muri hano.
All of you who are here.
Turi hano.
We are here.
Ntabwo twe twagira hariya mwijuru.
We have not reached here.
Ariko kandi twavuye mwisi.
But we have
left. Aha hari ukuntu tuhifata.
There is a way we have to behave in here.
Hari ukuntu tuhifata.
There is a way we have to
behave. Aha hari ama escalier d'abord.
There are stairs.
Ngomba kuzamura akaguru.
I have to lift up my leg.
Ntabwo ngenda nkugenda hariya.
I do not walk.
Uri hariya yigendera.
Those who are there, they walk normally.
Ariko hano ngomba kureba ukuntu
nifata. But here I have to go to the other stair.
Mwese hari wari waje Burundi.
All of you.
Have, iyo ugeze ku Kanyaru hari ikintu gitangaje.
When you go to Akanyaru, there is something Kanyaru. Amazing. When you get there,
wambuka umupaka w'u Rwanda.
You cross the border of Rwanda.
Mbere yo kugera ku mupaka w'i Burundi.
Before getting to the border of
Burundi. Iyo uhuye n'abarundi,
when you meet Burundians,
bakuramutsa mu Kinyarwanda.
They will greet you in Kinyarwanda.
Ariko uhuye n'abanyarwanda bakakuramutsa mu Kirundi.
But when you meet people from Rwanda, they will greet you in Kirundi.
Baritegura aho bagiye kugera.
Because they are preparing to go to the other country.
Amen.
Amen.
Batangiye kwitegura.
They start preparing.
Batangiye kwitegura.
They start preparing.
Bara bari hagati.
Nibari bagera Burundi. They are not yet in Burundi. But they have left Rwanda there. They no longer want to be like Rwandese. They want to speak Kirundi. Because that's where they're heading to. It is funny, but it's true. Recently we went to
Cyanika.
Those who don't know Cyanika, that's where we
were. The
Ugandan border is like 50 meters from there.
Hari imirima twagiraga kera ariko umurimo ukaba ni Buganda ariko ari umurimo umwe.
We used to have one field, a part of it would be in Rwanda and the other one in Burundi.
Tugejobundi.
And when we got there recently,
dushaka kugura ibirayi.
We wanted to buy some potatoes.
Sinzi ukuntu nabyibutse ariko dushaka kugura ibirayi.
We wanted to buy
potatoes. Umusore warimo agurisha ibirayi.
The guy who was selling
ari mu Rwanda.
He's in Rwanda.
kuko abaganda baza kugura ibirayi mu Rwanda.
Because Ugandans come to buy potatoes from Rwanda. You can bless God.
Ambwira atubwira ikiganda.
He started talking to us in Kiganda.
Atubwira ikiganda.
He spoke in Kiganda.
Naga tubwira ikiganda ngo ibirayi biragura imitwaro 11 ngo.
And he said, this is the price of potatoes.
Kuko.
Because he's looking at us, we are
Rwandans.
Probably there are some who wants to buy to give people to sell. They want to talk in Kiganda so that we are convinced that they are going there. He spoke to us in Kiganda. He spoke to us in Kiganda language. He could understand and he replied, it was not
to Rwanda.
He's in between. He's in between.
As yuko,
he knows that the Rwandans who are going to go to Uganda, they speak Kiganda. Not only they speak Uganda, but they also want to speak it so that they might convince others that they're going there. That's where we are. We are here. We want to go the other step. We were there.
He
said, beloved, now we are children of God. But what will be like, what will look like, it has not yet been revealed. But when we will get there, will look like Christ. Because at that time, Jesus will be here. I'll be looking at him face to face. But I'm not yet there. I'm not yet there. Now let me be here. But the person who is here, there is a way they have to leave so that they might go to the other country. There are things that characterize that person. Because going to the other country, you don't just flow into it. You don't just
sleep.
You have to make a conscious effort to get there. But also, there is another thing. Here, I can go back.
There,
but I don't want to go back there. So that I do not go back, let me stay here. Here,
by myself,
so that I might go to the other state and go to the other one. And so that on that day, I will be there.
Hallelujah.
Amen. This is where he says that I do not think that I have already attained it. I have not yet attained it. But that's where I'm heading to. That's my destination. Here now. It's a very crucial place. Because every Christian is here. This is where we are being purified. And this is where we are being strengthened. And this is where you become a Christian. This is where, this is the place where we can look at you and say this person is heading to heaven because you have started behaving as people who live in heaven. You have started behaving well.
Amen.
Amen.
You're
speaking the language of heaven. Every Christian has to go by here. They have to pass by here. They have to. Here, they have to pass by.
Amen.
Amen. They pass by here. This is where Israel was when they had left Egypt, but they were not yet in the promised land. This is where Jonah was inside the fish, the big fish, the well. This is where Daniel was when he was in the lion's den. Here. This is where you're being purified. Here. The Israel from Egypt to the promised land, it's a 3 days trip. When the children of Jacob went from Egypt to Israel to Egypt, it took them very short time. But when they found themselves in the plan of God, You used to walk as you pleased long time ago.
Kera nta rubanza rwari rukuriho.
There was no judgment for you, no condemnation.
Waratukanaga ugasinzira.
You will insult someone and you'll be at
ukarwana,
peace.
Ugasinzira.
You will fight with someone and you still
ugasinda,
be okay.
Ukashi,
you will get drunk and you'll be
ariko,
happy, but
ariko,
however.
Uburabikora ntiwa ntusinzira.
Today if you will do it you'll not find sleep in the night.
Kuko
because
kera
before
wari nta mayiragira warigenderaga tu
you were just doing
warigenderaga uko ushaka
there was no regulations for you
ariko uyu munsi
but today
kugira ngo ugende
for you to walk
uzamura akaguru
you have to move the leg
uzamura akaguru
you have to raise
your leg ushaka
you don't walk as you please
kuko
because
uritunganiriza kuzagira hariya
You're preparing yourself to
Kanda
get to the
country.
And those who go there, they are not those who walked as they pleased.
Hallelujah.
Amen. One thing I do. I do not do two things. I do not do three things. One thing I do. I want to tell you. Many people. Almost all of us actually. There are very few who can do two things at the same time. They like to say that women are multitasking. And the left hand will be writing. While the right hand will be preparing potatoes. But
very
few women who can do that. Paul said, one thing I do. Just one thing. Let us do one thing, beloved.
No,
there are some Kinyarwanda sayings that say that you should do one thing. Just do one thing. Yeah, let's do one thing. Or choose one way.
He
says, I do not think that I have already got hold of it. But one thing I do. That one thing. That one thing. This is the very important thing. This is the very important thing. He said, you know, you can't do two things. When you do two things at the same time, you might not do well one thing. There is a beloved here. He's here. Try to give him a hand while looking at the other side. Not looking at him. Because I can't greet my sister. Why I'm talking to Pastor Eddie?
Because
my heart can't be set on two things at the same time. Either the one I'm greeting, I will do it anyhow. Or I'll be telling wrong things to Pastor Eddie. It's not coming from my heart. Then he said, one thing I do. You know, there is one thing. People who are very intelligent, they have some problems. They have problems sometimes. People who are very intelligent. Let me give you an example. I had a friend of mine who was very intelligent. I like to say that if that person was a Christian. If you were a Christian at that time, he might have told you the whole Bible. He would have memorized it all. But if you ask him, who is Jesus? He will tell you the whole Bible for him to tell you who Jesus is. So that friend of mine, you might ask him, is it going to rain today? And he will start
talking. You
know the world rotates in this direction. And when the world is going in the west, the wind will go in the east and the wind will go over the sea.
amazi yashyushijwe n'izuba
ngo bikagenda byagera ku isi
hanyuma bigashyuha bikajya hejuru bikaza gukonja ugatega ko akubwira niba imvura iri bugwe cyangwa itari bugwe
ukagura
ariko urumva ibintu nakubwira byose
nibyo
nakubwiye kimwe umubajije
wigendere
urumva muri byinshi
So in those many things,
dufite,
many things that we have,
tuzi,
that we know,
reka tumenye icyangombwa.
Let us know the important thing.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Reka tumenye icyo dushaka.
Let us know what we want.
Reka tumenye icyo ari cyo.
Let us know what it is.
Ngo umusore umwe,
one young man,
muri Yohana 9 umurongo mu 20
in John chapter 9 in the verses
umugabo yarimo
someone was a young man was blind none
Yesu araza toba akonda mushya ku maso umugabo arahumuka
and Jesus came and he made mud and he put on his eyes and that guy ariko abafarisayo
bagira ikibazo no umusore
but the Pharisees had a problem with that young man
bakamaze ngo ari kuhuka kuvuye nini
and they ask him who is that person who heals you how did he heal you by the way
uza afite imbaraga
What is the power he has of healing you? And at some point when he got angry, when he was annoyed, he said, don't ask me many things. One thing I know is just one thing. I was blind and now I see. I can see you.
Now, uko byagenze?
The way the process went through and how it happened, I do not care about that. I do not care about that. I'm not concerned about that just as you are. The important thing is that I was blind and I know that yesterday, I saw today and I know yesterday I was blind. And he said that's the important thing.
Yesu ngo yagiye gusura Martha na Mary.
Jesus want to see Martha and Mary, his sister.
Martha mubonye ajya gushashyana.
Martha when he met Jesus, she went and tried to prepare something.
Ashaka kugamura.
She wanted to
Martha araza ngo ajya ku birenge bya Yesu.
And Mary came, she went at the feet of Jesus.
No, Martha za kuza kuregera Yesu.
And Martha came to tell Jesus about his sister.
Ati tuzi kushonje.
And say we know you're hungry.
Kandi byarukuri.
And it was true, actually.
Yes, you are ashamed.
Jesus was hungry.
Ati ngaho murumuna wanje yamfashije tukagutekera tukabugaburira.
My sister, instead of coming to help me to prepare some food and feed you, she came and she sat with you.
Ariko Yesu yaramubwiye.
But Jesus told her.
Ati hari ibintu bibiri.
Say there are two things.
Hari gushashyana ushaka kungaburira.
There is preparing.
Hari no kunyumva.
And there is hearing.
Ati muri ibyo.
He say among those two.
Hagomba gutoranya mu kimwe.
We have to choose one.
Kuko byombi ntiwabikoramo
mu. Because you can't do both.
Ariko muri ibyo byombi yo dutoranije.
But if you try to choose between the two.
Dutoranya icyangombwa.
We choose the better part.
Icyangombwa.
The important part.
Icyangombwa.
The important thing.
Nuko nicyo Maria atoranije.
Is what Mary has chosen.
Icyangombwa nuko Maria yumva Yesu.
The important thing was for Mary to listen.
Nuko yicara iruhande rwa Yesu.
It was for her to see.
Nuko yigishwa na Yesu.
It was to be taught by Jesus.
Ibindi byaza bikurikira.
And the rest will come after.
Amen.
Amen.
Rero abantu
people
twebwe
us
wagira ngo hari ikintu kidusunika.
You think that there is something driving us or pushing us.
Hari ikintu kidusunika.
There is something driving us.
Twirirwa twiruka.
We are always running.
Twirirwa twiruka.
Running here and there.
Ngo birihutirwa.
You say this thing is urgent. This is urgent.
Ibi birihutirwa.
This is urgent.
Ariko wajya kureba.
But if you try to
ugasanga muri byo byihutirwa.
You find that among those urgent things.
Byishe ibyangombwa.
It is hindering the important.
Kuko dushobora kubikora.
Because you can't do at the same time those two things. You can't do it at the same time. So there is something that has to come first and there is something that will come second. But this that will come second, it can wait for the first thing to happen. He said, one thing I know. What did he want to mean by that? He said it. He said, one thing I know. I forget what is past and try to attain what is ahead. of me.
Twavuze ko udashobora gukora ibintu bibiri ngo ubikorere rimwe.
We say that it's almost impossible to do two things at the same time.
No kuvuga ko udashobora no gukora.
It means you can't
ukibuka.
You can't perform while you're remembering.
Kwibagirwa.
Forgetting.
Paul avuga hano.
That Paul is saying here.
Ntimukwitiranye no kwibuka.
Don't confuse it with remembering.
Kuko.
Because.
Bibiliya nayo iratubwira.
The Bible says.
Ngo ntimukibagirwe.
That you shouldn't forget.
Abayisraeli Imana yarababwiye.
God said to the Israelites,
he
said, when you get to that land, when you plant and you harvest, when you eat and you
fruit,
and when you have many children, say, do not forget. Do not forget where God took you from. So he's not the God who tells us to forget today. We have to remember. And God knows that we have to remember. Even when you try to delete things on the computer, it's not like you delete them completely. They are stored somewhere. But what Paul means here, he say he does not want the past things to tie us. Why we are going back to those stairs. Paul doesn't want to mean he doesn't mean that
we
should look like here and today we're here and tomorrow we look back and we forget. We go back here. We should forget. You know when Paul said the former things, what he used to do, for him it was like garbage. Do you think it is only bad things? Even good things? He forget that. He puts it aside. It was for that time.
Amen.
Amen. There is a way you used to walk here. Whether you behave well, but when you have got to the other step, what has happened there, it is over. Forget that. So that your sight might be ahead.
Amen.
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 That is the forgetting they are talking about. Because
Paul,
he had many things to forget. There are many wrong things he did. When they were killing Stephen, he was there. He tortured the church. He persecuted the church. He persecuted the gospel. We can say that those were the wrong things. But there are good things that he did. He planted many churches. And he has taught many people. He was being persecuted because of Jesus. But all that, he said it was for some time. Today, he's forgetting, he's putting it aside because what he's looking at, it is the finishing line the brother Lambert talked about. You can't run in that direction while your eyes are looking back.
Amen.
Amen. Why is it good that we should forget some things? You know that you do not miss things that you have forgotten. Because missing something, it comes from remembering those things. Let us read. Exodus chapter 16, verse 2 to 3. The second verse says, in the desert, the whole community grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The Israelites said to them, if only we had died by the Lord's hand in Egypt. There we sat around pots of meat and ate all the food we wanted, but you have brought us out into this desert to starve this entire assembly to death.
Iteraniro ry'Abisirayeli ryose ryivovotera Mose na Aaron mu butayu ngo barababwira bati ngo twicirwa n'Uwiteka mu gihugu cya Egiputa tukicaye ku nkono z'inyama tukirya ibyo kurya tugahaga ngo none mwadukuyeyo mutuzanira muri ubu butayu kutwicisha inzara n'iteraniro ryose. Urumva? Urumva?
Here now.
He remembered.
They remained about pots of meat. In Numbers 11, chapter
5,
the Israelite cried again to God. He said,
Inyama zo kurya.
who will give us meat to eat?
Ngo twibutse ya mafi twariraga ubusa turi muri
Egypt. Remember the fish we ate in Egypt at no cost.
Ngo twibutse amadegete.
And melons.
Ngo twibutse amapapayi.
And papayas.
Ngo twibutse ubutunguru bw'ibibabi n'ubw'ibijumba.
And the onions and the garlics.
Ngo twibutse n'udutungurusumu.
And the garlic.
Amen.
Amen.
Mufebene dat. Abagabo bari bafite ngo umugozi kwijosi.
The men had a rope tied on their neck.
Hari nubwo tudutungurusumu twahumuraga ntibashobore no kuturya.
And there are times they could smell this garlic but they couldn't eat it.
Hano bararya ibyo kurya bivuye mu ijuru.
Here they are eating food from heaven.
Bafite isezerano ryo kugera kuri.
They have a promise of going far.
Ariko ngo bibutse inkono.
But they remembered those pots.
Ngo bibutse amapapayi.
They remembered the popo.
Kwibuka kubateje gucumura.
And remembering caused them to sin.
Kwibuka kubabujije kureba ibiri imbere.
Remembering kept them from looking ahead.
Kuri kwibuka kubabujije kubona umugisha bafite.
Remembering kept them from seeing the blessing they have.
Umugisha ubibagije ibitangaza byo mu Egypt.
Remembering hindered from remembered from remembering the miracles in Egypt.
Bibagiwe ukuntu baciye mu nyanja.
They forgot how they crossed the Red Sea.
Abaheburayo 11:15.
Hebrews 11.
Havuga neza.
Verse 5 says it well.
Baravuga mu magambo make. Ngiyo bakumbura iyo bavuye.
If they miss the place
to go, barabonye uburyo bwo gusubirayo.
They could have found the way of going back.
Iyo Mose ataba umuntu w'Imana.
If Moses was not a man of God.
Yari kuvuga ati niba munaniye.
He would say, okay.
Okay, dusubireyo.
Let's go back.
Dusubireyo.
You don't want to go, let's go back.
Bari gusubirayo.
They would have went back.
Ariko Yesu aravuga ngo.
But Jesus said.
Ngo yifashe isuka.
That when you take a hoe.
Ngo yifashe isuka. Ngo nta muntu ufata isuka.
You do not take it and look back.
Say
those who look back, they are not fit for the kingdom of God. When you leave that place and look back, it means you are not fit for the kingdom of God. We should forget that place. Another thing, there are many people who died there.
Yesu yaravuze nyine haruguru yaha yaravuze ngo mwibuke mukaroti.
Jesus said, remember the wife of Lot.
Mukaroti yishwe niki?
Why did she die?
No kutibagirwa yavuye.
She died because she didn't forget where she was.
Hari itegeko.
There was a law.
Hari itegeko umareka yabahaye.
There was an instruction.
Yaravugaga ngo muhunge mudapfa.
He said, flee for your lives.
Ngo ntimurebe inyuma.
Say, do not look back.
Ngo kandi ntimutinde mu kibaya.
And do not delay in the valley.
Ngo muhungire ku musozi.
Say, run to the mountain so that you might not perish.
Aho cyari gikwiriye.
So the thing that was to be done there.
Kwari ukwiruka ugahunga.
It was to run for your life.
Ariko Mukaroti yibutse inyuma.
But the wife of Lot, she remembered the country she was coming from and what happened.
Icyo byamuviriyemo.
What the result of that?
Nuko atageze iyo bajyaga.
Is that she didn't reach
Nuko
the destination. She was not saved.
Rero bene data.
Beloved.
Kwibagirwa Imana iziko bitoroshye.
God knows that it is not easy to forget.
Ariko.
But.
Irabiduhembera.
He rewards us for that.
Irabiduhembera.
He rewards us.
Amen.
Amen.
Reka dusome.
Let us read.
Turebe ukuntu Imana ibihembera.
Let us see how God rewards us for forgetting.
Tangiriro 41.
Genesis chapter 41.
Kuva ku murongo wa 50.
From verse 50.
N'abana ba Yosefu.
These are the children of Joseph.
Uko aha Yosefu aratubwira.
Here Joseph is telling us.
Ubuzima bwe.
His life.
Yabukubiye mu mazina y'abana.
His life, he got names for his children. Looking at what has happened.
Amazina y'abana be.
The names for his children.
Ni resume.
Is a summary.
Y'ibyabaye kuri Yosefu.
Of what has happened to Joseph.
Yosefu muzi ukuntu byabaye.
You know what happened to him.
Muzi ukuntu yavuye iwabo.
You know how he left his father's home.
Muzi ukuntu yageze muri Egypt.
You know how he got to Egypt.
Muzi byamubereho muri Egypt.
I know what happened to him in Egypt.
Muzi ukuntu habaye.
You know how he lived there.
Amazi imyaka.
After many years,
Imanira,
God remembered him. But he remembered him.
Joseph, afite karite.
Joseph had some qualities.
Karite.
Some qualities.
Karite.
Some qualities.
Zitareba inyuma.
That were not looking back.
Ahubwo.
Rather,
areba ibyo uwo munsi.
He was looking at the present.
Amen.
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 Abinyuma bamugire nabi yarabibagiwe.
Those who did wrong to him, he had forgotten.
Kandi
about
benshi.
Them, and there were many.
Umuryango we.
His family.
Wamugire nabi.
They did wrong to him.
Shebuja yamugiriye nabi.
His master did wrong to him.
Imfungwa abaprisonier bagenzi bamugiriye nabi.
His fellow prisoners, they did wrong to him.
Yarafite ibintu byinshi byinshi byo kwibuka byo kumubabaza.
He had so many things to remember that would have caused him.
Ariko byose.
But all of
that,
if truth forgets,
kubera kubyibagirwa,
and because of forgetting,
kubera kubishyira inyuma,
because of putting it,
kubera kutabiha agaciro,
because of not valuing those things,
kubera avuga ati ubuzima bwanjye n'ubwo uyu munsi subwo ibyashize,
because he said that my life is the present, not what has happened in the past.
Imana iraza iramwibuka.
God came and he remembered.
None mu yita abana amazina amazina.
And now he named his sons.
Ariko amazina nituyasoma,
but when we read this,
urasanga arimo asobanura,
it is explaining
uko byabaye,
what has happened to him,
naho hageze,
and where he has got so far.
Reka dusome.
Let us read.
Itangiriro 41.
Genesis chapter 41.
Kuva ku murongo wa 50.
Verse 50.
Ngo Yosefu abyara abahungu babiri ngo inzara itaratera. Ababyarana na Sinati umukobwa wa Potifari umutambyi wo mu mudugudu wa One. Yosefu yita imfura ye Manase. Rivuga ngo kubera iki amwise Manase? Ngo mwise Manase?
Why did he call him Manase?
Ngo nuko Imana yanyibagije umuruho wanjye wose w'inzu ya data. Urumva ntabwo kwibagirwa akwishyizeho.
He doesn't put it on him that forgetting.
Kuko kwibagirwa bitoroshye.
Because it is not easy to forget.
Ukwibagirwa nako tugusaba Imana.
We get it from God. We ask God to help us forget.
Imana ikagira ukuntu idufasha.
And God helps us.
Tugashobora kwibagirwa.
And we are able to forget.
Ngwa kabiri amwite Ephraim bivuga ngo kuko Imana yanyororokereje mu gihugu naboneyemo umubabaro. Ngwa mbere amwise Manase.
He called the firstborn Manasseh.
Atimana nyibagije umuruho.
He said God has made me forget all my trouble.
Ashimi Imana ko Imana amwibagije umuruho.
He's praising God because he made him forget all the trouble.
Abyaye wa kabiri.
And he had the second son.
Amwita Ephraim.
And he called him Ephraim.
Ati kuko Imana, Imana.
God
yanyororokereje, yampaye prosperity, yampaye, yanteje imbere.
Has made me fruitful.
Mu gihugu.
In the land.
Cy'umuruho.
Of my suffering.
Kandi data.
Beloved,
these are
hard words. The firstborn Manasseh, he said, God,
Ati,
I praise you
Ati,
because you have made me forget my trouble and hardships. And he had the second son. He said, God, I praise you because you have exalted me. You have exalted me in the land where I should be suffering. What does this mean? Let us be patient because God has
Manasseh
for us. God has Manasseh for you. God has a reward. God has something for you. But you get it when you have been patient. You get it because you have reached the place God wanted you to have that thing. You do not get it while you're there sleeping. It's somewhere. And you have to reach that very place. You have to reach it. And reaching that place is not by all might.
Imana,
but God,
Imana iri kumwe natwe,
when he's with
Imana
us,
hamwe nawe,
the God who is with you,
kuhagera,
he will help you get to that place, so that one day,
uzatubwire,
one day you might
uti
tell
umusi,
us that today,
uti mfite Manasseh,
say today I have
uti umusi,
Manasseh, today
Imana yibagije imiruho yanjye yose,
God has made me forget all my hardships,
bya bindi byose nibagiwe,
God has made me forget all those things I forgot,
Imana ibishyizeho kashe,
God has put a seal.
Amen.
Amen.
Kuko bene dat.
Because beloved.
Inzira y'umusaraba.
The way of to the cross.
Abayise neza ariko kwita inzira y'umusaraba.
They say the path of the cross.
Ni umusaraba koko.
It is the cross.
Yango bavuga umusaraba bavuga ibintu bikomeye.
When they say the cross, I think inzira yacu turimo hardships. The way we are going through.
Inzira y'ubukristo.
Our path.
Ntabwo byoroshye.
It is not easy.
Ugomba gushyira makawu.
You have to put some effort.
Ugomba kwihangana.
You have to be patient.
hari icyo bigusaba.
There is something, there is a cost to that.
Uziko ushobora kuba uri nyangamugayo bakakwita ngo uri igicucu.
You know, you might have integrity and people will call you a fool.
Ugakoresha ukuri bakakubwira ngo ariko ngo muri iki gihugu ninde ukivugisha ukuri.
You will be someone who says the right things and they will say no one is no longer using the truth here.
Ugakora neza bakaguseka.
You do well and you'll be despised for that.
Ariko ntabwo ukorera abantu.
But you're not working for
your hands. Urakorera uriya.
You're working for God.
Uriya arakureba.
And the one he's looking at you.
Azaguhe.
And that one will reward you.
Uwo ni ureba.
Look at him. Uwo ni ureba. He's the one to be looked at. When he had a second one, he named him Ephraim. Why wouldn't he call him Ephraim? A place you went as a slave. She was a slave when he went there. And you went there and you ruled. You become a ruler. You become a ruler. Why can't he call him Ephraim?
Ariko siwe gusa.
But he's not the only one.
Ntabwo yikoreye kuko yitwa Joseph.
He didn't do it just because he was Joseph.
Niba witwa Maria nawe yabigukorera.
If you're Mary, he can still do that to you. Even if you're called Josephine, he can still do that for you. Even if you're named Elizabeth, he can still
Freddy,
do that for you.
Freddy,
God can do that to you.
It's
not just them. God can do it for you.
But
there is a way we have to behave for God to do that. There is a way we have to behave for God to do that. It's just one way. It's to behave properly here. While we're here. While we're here. This is the note. This is the core of it. It's just there. It's just there. It's just there. So the important thing, beloved, is to behave well while we're there. This is where we need to have these values we are talking about. It is what characterizes us, what enables us to go far. Because all of you who are here, except those who have not yet received Jesus, here we are. This is where we are.
How agusize?
No one has gone.
Ntabwuri inyuma.
There is no one who is
intambwe neja tugusuka bugeza.
It's just three stairs and you'll be here.
Ariko izo ntambwe ni intambwe z'abagabo.
But these are steps for men. These are steps you need to say. Today I'm going to choose one way. I will choose one way. Whether I say it in the wrong way or the right way, but you know what I mean. And I will also choose one thing. Whether I say it in a good Kinyarwanda or a bad one, it's just here and it's here. Whether you say that you got it, if you don't want to get it, the steps here, this is where you are. I'm not the one who is going to pull you up here. It's not what I say that is going to pull you up. I'm not just going to be an excuse for you.
Amen.
Amen. And I won't have another excuse. I'm also striving to attain. Because whoever has this hope, they purify themselves. And you purify yourself here. Here. This is where we purify ourselves. Let's purify ourselves. It's not what we hear. It's not what we do. It is between us and God. You won't tell God, you know.
Oh yeah. No.
Because he has enabled you to step here. What he's expecting from you and what he wants is for you to come to this level.
Yes, adumugisha.
May God help us and bless us. May God bless
us. Yes, adumugisha.
May God bless us.
Kandi twabonye.
And we have seen.
Utari wahagera.
That before getting there,
Imana iragufasha.
God will help
kugira ngo uhagere.
So that you can get there.
Igufasha iguha Ephraim.
He helps you giving you
Ephraim. Ikaguha Manasseh.
And he gives you Manasseh.
Wo kugutera inkunga.
To encourage you.
Ukavuga ngo ari kuzikoko ya mani hari.
And you say, oh, that
God
is.
Kandi ubuzima bwanyu mwese.
In all your life.
Mwese ariko.
All of you.
Ngira ngo hari cyo Imana yagukoreye.
I'm sure that God has done something for you.
Tuguhagurikije ntakubaza ntariko mbwira.
If you can ask you.
Mbwira ikintu kimwe.
Tell me one thing.
Wakwita Manasseh.
That you can call Manasseh.
Ikintu Imana imwe yaguhaye ukibagirwa ibibi waciyemo.
Something that God has given you and it
has made you forget. Dukira urutoki hejuru.
What things you went through. Please lift up your hands. We all have it.
Bitwereka ko Imana iri kumwe natwe.
This means that God is with us. It is not about fighting for ourselves, but God is with us and He's helping us. He's pushing us. However, for you to, you need to do something. Tell us. He didn't name that child Manasseh only. He said the reason why he named him Manasseh. He gave a testimony. We also want testimonies of what God is doing in you. Because that one,
bizadufasha.
It will encourage.
Imbaraga zo kuzamuka.
It will encourage us and give us strength to
neza.
Come. Up.
Yes,
may God bless you. May God help you. I hope that you won't stay there. But one day, we'll see him face to face. And that day,
hallelujah.
Amen. We'll be looking like him. Who are those who miss to look like Jesus? Those who long to see him. Let us stand up. Let us stand up and pray. Let's pray.
Ariko ntabwo twibagiwe ko hari abataratera intambwe.
But we won't forget that there are some who have not yet made that step.
Niba utarakira Yesu.
If you have not yet received Jesus,
uri hano.
You're still here.
Nakubwiye.
I told you that it is just one
simple
thing to get here. It is to say, Jesus, I welcome you, come in my life. If you have not yet received Jesus, don't go back being at the same level. Come here. Let us help you
yes,
go to the other step.
Yes,
let Jesus help you to go to the next step. So that the prayer we are going to have, it won't leave you as you were. But let us all go out of this place. Having reached this level, I want you to say,
no turning back.
No turning back. No turning back. No turning
back.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, mighty God, you are a mighty God, you are an amazing God, because even now we have done a miracle to us. The first is that you have took us from where we were and here we
are.
I can say that this is the biggest miracle we have experienced from the day we were born. And today we can say confidently that today we are children of God. That we are children of God. We are children of God because you made us to be. And you took us from where we were. And we are in between heaven and earth. But we are on our way heading to heaven. Lord God Almighty. There is nothing good we have seen where we were. And there is nothing that can make us go back. But we are looking ahead at the good things you have for us. Our eyes are fixed on you. Let us forget what is past and help us to do one thing, to fix our eyes on you. Mighty God, I'm praying for all the beloved
ones.
Whoever have a problem of continuing, please give them Manasseh. Manasseh will help them to forget.
Ariko kandi,
but also,
akabereka ko uhari,
and show them that you're there.
Akabereka aho bagana.
Where they are heading.
Manushobora byose ba Ephraim.
Please God, give them Ephraim.
Ephraim, manu muhu mukeneye.
Ephraim, give Ephraim to whoever needs.
Mana aho avuga ngo.
And those who will say.
Gogoko ndi kumwe n'Imana.
Those who say that I'm with God.
Because
yesterday I used to be this person, today this is who I am.
Kandi uyu munsi aruta uwejo.
And the person who is here today is better than the
Bakomeze
one
rero mana,
who was yesterday.
Baha imbaraga.
Strengthen them.
Bizera ko mana umunsi umwe bazakubona.
Help them believe that one day they will see you.
Kandi ibyo twacamo byose uko bingana.
And whatever we might go through, whatever it might be, there is nothing.
Twahwanya.
That can
no kuzakubona.
Equal to see
kuko kukubona.
Because seeing you.
Nicyo gihembo.
That will be the kimwe reward.
Chonyine.
That you will be the one
kimwe
reward.
Chonyine.
The one reward.
Kimwe rukumbi.
The only one reward.
Mana kizadushimisha.
That will make us happy.
Ngo kuko icyo gihe.
Because that day.
Ngo tuzaba dusa nawe.
Will look like you.
Ngo kuko tuzaba tukureba amaso kuyana.
Because we'll see you face to face.
Urakoze rero.
Thank you God.
Urakoze kutugira neza.
Thank you for doing a
Urakoze.
Good
place. Ibyiringiro ubuduhaye.
Thank you for the hope you're giving
Urakoze
us.
Urakoze kutwerekana iyo nzira.
Thank you for showing us
the way.
So that we might walk in it.
Dushikamye.
Being firm.
Kandi nta gusubira inyuma.
No one turning back.
Icyubahiro kibi cyawe.
May all the glory be yours.
Mu izina rya Yesu.
In the name of Jesus. Amen.